Hello students, this is your course on Digital Marketing Basics. In this video on important terms in digital marketing, we are going to learn about the term click-through rate or CTR. Now, what is CTR or what is click-through ratio? This click-through ratio or click-through rate is basically a percentage of users or potential customers who click on your ad compared to the total number of users who were exposed to the ad, or let's say who had the impression of the ad. It's very much applicable for search engines, social media, video, display ads, as well as email campaigns, and is a very popular, very commonly used terminology in digital marketing. Simply put, if you are planning to be a digital marketer, then you would obviously be required to design, plan, execute several digital campaigns. And for every campaign, this is going to be a measure of success. This is going to be a metric which you would be asked a number of times, that for a particular campaign, what was the CTR and what can be done to improve the CTR for future campaigns. Now, there's a very simple formula which can be used to calculate CTR or click-through rate. It is total measured clicks divided by total measured impressions into 100. Now, how do you find out what are the total measured clicks, or how do you find out what are the total measured impressions? Usually, this is the data which the server can provide you wherever you are hosting your advertisement. And this is an information which you can get based on the traffic that is coming to your website. And in most campaigns where you cannot really measure that what is the conversion rate for an ad campaign, CTR is the next best thing which can be measured. Let's take a look at the example. I think it will explain the whole concept better. Let's say if 1 lakh customers saw your ad on social media, Facebook, let's say, or Google. This is an information which will be available to you in terms of impressions made by the ad. So if let's say the ad is for designer purses, okay, and anytime a user is searching anything relevant to purses, designer accessories, designer purses, designer purse in my area, or relevant keywords around which you have designed your ad, and the page loads which has your ad, that is going to be counted as an impression by the server for your particular ad. So let's say there are 1 lakh impressions generated in a period of 1 month for the ad campaign that you ran. And out of those 1 lakh impressions, 1 lakh customers who searched anything relevant or search anything related to whatever your ad was about, out of those 1 lakh customers, about 5,000 of them clicked on it to land on your website and explore more about your product or maybe buy the product. Now, this 5,000 customers who actually clicked on your ad are measured clicks, total measured clicks. These are the people who clicked on the impression of the ad generated for them. So your click-through ratio would become about 5% with the given formula of 5,000 divided by 1 lakh into 100. So very easy to calculate, and yet the most critical thing that you need to track for any digital marketing campaign. In case of email campaigns or email marketing campaigns, this can become the click-through ratio can become total measured clicks divided by total measured open rate. Open rate as in number of customers who opened the email becomes the denominator, and the number of customers who actually clicked on the link provided in the email to land on your web page would become the total measured clicks. So the number of customers who received the mail is not the denominator. Those who opened and then those who clicked are the ones that feature in the CTR calculation. Now, these are typical CTR benchmarks which digital marketers are required to try and beat whenever they are deciding or designing on a digital campaign. So if you're deciding to go on search engines, with your digital marketing ad campaign, 5% is considered as a good benchmark. That is, at least as we discussed in the previous example, out of 1 lakh impressions, at least 5,000 customers should be landing on your page. But anything above that is considered as a successful, a good digital marketing campaign. For display ads, the ratio is actually very low because the customer is not successfully interested in whatever the display ad is talking about. They're not really specifically searching for it. There is no keyword connection that you can really establish, and it's something which could be in their feed, which could be just on the page, and they may or may not get interested in it. So the CTR is usually very low, about 0.2%, and therefore these are cheaper to buy also, and anything above 0.2% is considered quite successful. In video advertisements, the engagement is relatively higher and customers are more likely to get attracted or interested in learning more. And therefore, the CTR benchmark is 10%. And for a successful campaign, digital marketers should be aiming to get anything above this. For Facebook, again, similar to display ad, since the ads are part of the feed, the customer is not specifically searching for the info and therefore may or may not be motivated to click on an ad. And therefore, a CTR benchmark of 1% is considered quite successful. Anything above it is very good. In email campaigns, however, since the CTR is having a denomination of number of customers opening the email, so the interest is actually evident in this step itself. Wherein a customer first reads the subject, chooses to open the email, and then the given the information within the email, chooses to click on the link provided and land on the page. Therefore, the CTR that can happen through a good email campaign can be above 20%. And therefore, the chances of success of a properly designed and executed email campaign are very high in leading to conversions as well. Now, in the next video, we'll be talking about content management system, which is again a very relevant, very popular term in digital marketing domain. Until then, thank you.